Now I'm going to bring out the cast, including a couple of ATX guest stars. So first, I'm going to introduce Robin Ross from our partner Entertainment Weekly. That's going to be also moderating and helping out. Creator Aaron Korsh. Meghan Markle. Gina Torres. And I'd like to announce newest ATX ambassador, Patrick J. Adams. Gabriel Mott. Rick Hoffman. Nick Wexler and Abigail Spencer.
I think we're here for a table read for the 100th episode of Suits to celebrate that. I wanted to start by saying I wrote this script, it seems like 100 years ago. And I was proud of it, but they were just words on the page until these six people made every person in this read come alive. I remember meeting all of them for the first time. It was amazing. And I want to say, having said all that, fuck up one line today. I'm recasting. All right, let's get started. You guys ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Can I just say one thing? In my recollection of this process of shooting the pilot, it was all improvised. So I don't know what that is.
Well, then let's close our scripts.
Lisa, I don't normally do this, but since we are celebrating, what time do you get off tonight?
Oh, I'm glad you asked. I get off at 10 past. I'm never going out with you.
No. Oh.
I guess you're not the best closer the city's ever seen.
Oh.
This feels like I'm playing the exact same way that we did. That's so
you
weird.
You did it so good.
Should we just kind of turn it on its end and do something different?
British accent.
Let's give it a shot.
Woo! There you go. Talk like this the whole time. Like, hey, what's up, buddy?
Second, the way our agreement works is the minute Cooper signed the deal, which gave you everything you wanted, our fee was due and payable.
Everybody knows. You've all seen it. He runs out. He bursts through the door. The proctor's chasing him. Mike doesn't know what to do. He turns left. He turns right. He runs into the bathroom. He takes his shirt off. He takes his glasses off. He's about to take the cap off, but he doesn't throw it in the trash can. He gets out of the room. Yeah. Takes his pants off. Takes his underwear off. His socks, his shoes, everything. At this point, if we had that cool song, you'd hear it. The mighty Donna Paulson. Harvey pokes his head out of the inner room.
Donna, we're going to need to streamline this. Give each guy a hard time. Before you send them back, give me a wink, and if they say something clever. Give me a wink if they say something clever. Okay?
Okay. What are you looking for?
Another me.
Mr. Sorkin, you're 5 minutes late. Is there a reason why I should let you in?
Look, I'm just trying to ditch the cops, okay? I don't really care if you let me in or not.
Harvey opens the door. Finally, we get a wink from Donna. They found the guy. He walks into the firm. He's stunned. It's amazing. He can't believe it. All of a sudden, out of nowhere.
Mike Ross?
He turns around. He's been hit by a bolt of lightning because he's met Rachel Zane.
Hi, I'm Rachel Zane. I'll be giving you your orientation.
Wow, you're pretty.
Okay, good. Good. You've hit on me. We can get out of the way that I'm not interested.
No. What? No, I'm sorry. I wasn't hitting on you.
Trust me, I've given dozens of these, and without fail, whatever new hotshot it is thinks that because I'm just a paralegal, that I will somehow be blown away by his dazzling degree, but let me assure you, I won't. Take notes. I'm not going to repeat myself.
She walks away.
I love you.
Civil liability associated with agency is based on several factors, including the deviation of the agent from his path, the reasonable inference of agency on behalf of the plaintiff, and the nature of the damages themselves.
How did you know that?
I learned it when I studied for the bar. I mean, it's cool. It's cool to see the beginning of, like, that line, I'm going to be the best goddamn lawyer you've ever seen, and to think now what we're shooting is he is the best, you know, under this guy, the best goddamn lawyer, and this lady. Okay, he's maybe not the best yet, but he's going to be there.
The 100th episode, here's the funny thing. We haven't even really finished writing it yet. We're going to shoot it in about 2 weeks. That's the way it goes on Suits, I'm sorry to say. But we have built to what we hope will be an awesome episode. We try to, you know, build a story that's really satisfying and really good, and hopefully it'll be another good episode.
Who out of the cast do you think would be most likely to make it as a real lawyer?
Oh. I'm so happy that, especially reading the pilot again, you get to see where she started, even saying, yeah, you know, talking about Harvey Specter and saying, but I don't really know him or work with him, and to watch that progression. She's worked so hard, and I love that as a role model, how she's been crafted to balance it all. But yeah, now have this place at the firm where she really knows her standing, and her office isn't just because she's a good researcher, it's because she's an associate. She's really earned that spot.